Here at home, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he will sign the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund bill as soon as he receives it. Marcos himself, though, acknowledged there were valid concerns raised in the establishment of the fund. But he says it all boils down to the fund's management.
I've been watching the discussions that have been going on the Maharlika Fund. And I say, that's all true. That's all true. You must worry about that. But the only way to make sure that we do not get into trouble, or the fund does not get into trouble, is that it's well and professionally managed. Kung korap ang ilagay mo dyan, korap talaga yan. Mana mawawala yung pera. Kung mahusay ang nilalagay mo dyan, ay lalaki yan at magagamit natin yung pondong yan.
Let's go now to the Philippine Central Bank announcing its latest policy decision.
The interest rate on the overnight deposit and lending facilities were thus retained at 5.75% and 6.7% respectively. The BSP's latest baseline projections continue to suggest a gradual return of inflation to the target band of 2 to 4% over the policy horizon. Average inflation for 2023 is projected to settle at 5.4%, slightly lower than the 5.5% previously, while the average inflation forecast for 2024 now stands at 2.9% from 2.8%. For 2025, the inflation rate is expected to average at 3.2%. Meanwhile, inflation expectations for 2023 are also lower, while those for 2024 and 2025 appear to have settled firmly within the target range. Both headline and core inflation decelerated further in May, due mainly to slower increases in the price of food and energy-related items, affirming expectations of a return to the target range by year's end. However, the balance of risk to inflation outlook continues to lean towards the upside due to the potential impact of additional transport fare increases and minimum adjustment, persistent supply constraints of key food items, El Nino weather conditions, and possible knock-on effects of higher toll rates on agricultural prices. Meanwhile, the impact of weaker than expected global economic recovery remains the primary downside risk to the outlook. While the domestic growth momentum is expected to remain intact over the near term, recent demand indicators suggest a likely moderation in economic activities over the policy horizon, reflecting the impact of the BSP's cumulative policy rate adjustments, as well as the weak global growth prospects. Given these considerations, the Monetary Board deems it appropriate to maintain current monetary policy settings to allow the BSP to further assess how inflation and domestic demand have responded to the tighter monetary conditions. However, lingering upside risk to inflation outlook also warrant continued vigilance against potential second round effects. Going forward, the BSP remains prepared to resume monetary tightening as necessary, in line with its data-dependent approach to ensuring price and financial stability.
Thank you, Governor. At this point, we would like to request Deputy Governor Dakila to elaborate on the BSP's inflation forecast for 2023, 2024, and 2025.
Thank you, Alicia. As the Governor has noted, we have revised our baseline inflation forecasts. So the average now for 2023 is at 5.4%. This is a downward adjustment from the 5.5% baseline that we had during the May policy meeting. And the main reasons for the adjustment are the lower than expected inflation outturn in May. And although this is still preliminary, we're looking at the lower month ahead forecast for June. Now, for 2024, we have revised the forecast from 2.8% to 2.9%. Again, the main driver would be a continued opening up of the economy, and the impact of now a more hawkish Fed. For 2025, this is the first time that we are extending our baseline forecast. So it stands at 3.2%, which is comfortably within our inflation target band. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Governor Dakila. We will now proceed to questions from our media friends. We will begin first with questions from those who are here in person. So are there any questions from the floor? Yes.
Sir, good afternoon. Joanne Po from PNA. Can you please expound on the 2024 forecast? What is the impact of continued reopening of the economy on inflation?
Opening up of the economy means stronger economic activity, and of course demand prospects are now stronger than what we had earlier assessed during the May meeting, and that will have some impact on prices. Although the adjustment is really quite minimal, as you would note, it's just 0.1% the total adjustment that we have done, and that the new baseline number is close to, but a little bit below the midpoint of the inflation target.
Inflation is not the opening of the economy. And our own numbers show that the growth of supply is just barely behind the growth of demand. So truly, this inflation is largely a supply-driven inflation. And what we notice is that the worst supply shocks have already happened. If you look at the month-on-month, the last large increase was, of course, a very large one. It was January. 1.7% in just 1 month, and seasonally adjusted about 1%. When you look at the average month-on-month starting February, it's actually way below 3 divided by 12. Okay, so that's the key. I mean, if the midpoint of our target is 3 divided by 12, that is the month-on-month. Of course, you have to adjust for seasonality. So if you look at the February, March, April, and May, the average is way below 3 divided by 12. Of course, that's also because it came from a very high number, right? So far, the month-on-month prints that we see are all consistent with the inflation rate falling below 4% before the end of the year. Unless another shock happens. Huh? Now, of course, since I joined the central bank, I cannot remember a more terrible year than 2022. If you look at 2022, only 1 month is, when you look at 22 month on month, only 1 month was consistent with the target. Of course, the worst one was the start of 2023, 1.7% in just 1 month. So So we were so unlucky to be hit by maybe 3 or 4 or even 5 separate supply shocks. We have the war. We had a shortage of fertilizer. We had a bad weather. Of course, we had affecting a lot of agricultural products. Of course, the most famous of which was the onions. Ano? But thank God, it seems that if you look at the month on month, we are clearly on our way towards normal. And the other thing that's outstanding about this recent bout of inflation is, in the past, the longest number of consecutive months that we exceeded 4% was 15. And this time it's what? It's at least 18? 18 months. So it breaks the record for previous inflation. But what they have in common is eventually the supply shocks dissipate because we raise interest rates to prevent second order effects.
As widely expected, the Banco Central ng Pilipinas is keeping rates steady at 6.25% on account of a gradual return of inflation rate to settle within acceptable ranges. In fact, the Banco Central's revising targets for inflation and projections from a 5.5% baseline. 2023 inflation is now at 5.4, 2024 inflation at 2.9, and 3.2 for 2025. This is, of course, on expectations of lower inflation, both headline and core inflation for 2023, which the Banco Central noted to have decelerated, expecting to return within the government's target range. The Banco Central is also saying risks continue in the aspects of oil and transportation, possible increases of prices there. Food prices, at least select food prices, and the BSP also included El Nino, and the sentiment hovering over the Philippines over a weaker global economic recovery as a possible upsides or downside risks to inflation. Okay, the Banco Central is saying it is maintaining rates to allow the BSP to assess how the economy responded to the successive rate hikes. This is more or less similar to the first position of the Federal Reserve. The Banco Central is also saying it may resume tightening if necessary.